Domini in aeternum cantabo. Per omnes generationes annunciabo fidelitatem tua. Et Filio, et Spiritui Sancto, sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amen. Oh. peccamus te.
Evangelium Dei, seretia manimas nostra. Christo.
Et cum Spiritu Tuo.
Sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Ioannem.
Gloria tibi, Domine.
In illo tempore, dixit Iesus Simoni Petro, Simon Ioannis diligis metrus his, dicit ei, etiam Domine, tuscis quia amo te, dicit ei, pace agnos meos, dicit ei iterum, Simon Ioannis diligis me, eitili, etiam Domine, tuscis quia amo te, dicit ei, asce agnos meos, dicit ei tertio, Simon Ioannis amos me, Constritatus est Petrus, quia dixit ei tertio, amas me, et dixit ei, Domine tu omnia nosti, tuscis quia amo te, dixit ei, pasce oves mea,
first letter of St. Paul, the Apostle of the Thessalonians. Brethren, we had confidence in our God to preach to you the gospel of God with much anxiety, for our exhortation was not from error, nor from impure motives, nor from guile, but is approved by God to be entrusted with the gospel, so we speak not as pleasing men, but God approves our hearts. Nor any pretext for avarice, God is our witness, nor have we sought glory from men, neither from you nor from others. Although as apostles of Christ we could have claimed a position of honor among you, still while in your midst we were as children, as if a nurse were cherishing her own children. So we, in our love for you, would gladly have imparted to you not only the gospel of God, but also our own souls, because you had become most dear to us. A continuation of the Holy Gospel according to John. At that time Jesus said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these? He said to him, Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. He said to him, Feed my lambs. He said to him a second time, Simon, son of John, do you love me? He said to him, Yes, Lord, you know that I love you. He said to him, Feed my lambs. And a third time he said to him, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter was grieved because he said to him a third time, Do you love me? And he said to him, Lord, you know all things. You know that I love you. He said to him, Feed my sheep. Before I begin, I just want to say we'll be taking up a collection afterwards for the shrine, and I ask you to be generous, to give a sign of thanks to the shrine for having allowed us to use their space. So we will take up a collection in a little bit. It can be hard, maybe for us, sitting here in this building, the small group that we are, to imagine what it was like to stand on that seashore in the early hours of the morning, looking over the Sea of Tiberias, smelling the ocean, the charcoal fire, the fish, and to imagine what it would be like to have Christ standing there in front of us and ask us, do you love me? It can be hard, maybe with all the incense, to imagine the risen Christ standing in front of us this Saturday morning, as he once did in front of Simon Peter on that Sunday morning, so many thousands of years ago. But our Mass, as beautiful as it is, all of the ceremonies we're performing, we're not trying to replicate that scene for you. We're not trying to bring back any of those moments from Jesus' life, the Last Supper, the crucifixion, that morning with the risen Christ on the ocean. We're not trying to play act. But we don't need to play act, because Jesus Christ is asking you that question. He asked it once of Simon Peter, but he doesn't just ask it to us in general, but to you. Do you love me? Do you love me? We came here not just to hear a nice Mass, pretty music, smell the incense. We came here to hear that question asked by Christ himself to me. Do you love me? I think our first reaction, if we allow Jesus to ask us that question, will be very similar to what Simon Peter said. Lord, nosti omnia, I'm here on a Saturday morning. I'm here at High Mass. Think of all the things I do in my life. Think of all the things I do for my children, all the things I do for my school, how I've been faithful to you. Lord, you know everything. You can see into my heart. You know that I love you as much as I can. I might fall. I might struggle, but I know your mercy is there with me. I know it, and I've come to it so many times in the past, from the moment of my baptism to every time I come to confession, to every time I come to the sacrifice of the Mass. I know you love me, Lord. Don't you know that I love you? But he asks us each again, do you love me? Love. Mother Teresa, whose canonization will be celebrated tomorrow, had all of her houses of the Missionaries of Charity. In each of their houses, over the crucifix above the altar, has the words, I thirst. Christ thirsting for the love of every person, asking that question to each of us, do you love me? She wanted to remind her sisters, Christ gives himself to each of us. He gives himself to you. He asks us that question because he wants our heart. He doesn't just need our time or our vocal prayers or one thing after another. He wants you. He wants me. And it's not a binary yes or no, you love him or you don't. It's a thirst for our love. Do you love me? Do you love me as I love you? Do you love me as you should? It's a desire to be on fire that grows every day without end. And Christ thirsts for it. He wants each of us, no matter how small our little sacrifices, the little parts of our life may be. He wants all of that and more. Do you love me? When we finally come up here today and we receive him and we open our mouths to receive him and into our hearts, he comes down and his words echo in us. Do you love me? Not with any love, but with his love, do you love him? We celebrate Pius X today, his famous motto, Instaurare Homini Christo, to restore all things in Christ. To have his love is not to be limited. To have the love of Christ is to make the world our altar, to consecrate everything to that love, to make it an all-consuming desire, to carry that question burning in my heart every day, every time I wake up, every time I go to sleep. Do I love you? That question he asked Peter at the beginning, I think, is almost maybe more important. Diligens me plus his. You love me more than these. Love of Christ in our hearts is a love for the world. To think of all those people in our lives, the faces we see every day, people who might lack hope, who lack home, who lack clothing, who lack maybe even legal papers from immigration, who lack friends, who lack God. If I love God more than these, how much do I have to spread the love of God? How many more people need to find that love? In our world today, so racked with violence and bigotry, racism, we know even in our own city, the fights we've been having, the discussions, the anger, discrimination. Do I see the face of Christ around me every day? And not only do I see it, but do I seek it out? Do I try to find Christ, to love him where he is? In those places in the city, maybe I don't want to go every day. Maybe I can't go every day. But what am I doing about it? In Jesus' name, Christus. In our church, where there's so much wrangling and criticism, do I see Christ in those people who I disagree with? Those people who might be misled and in error, do I pray for them? The people who are living the life God wants them to, religious, holy lay people, do I pray for them? Do I seek them out? Do you love me? We're here not to just to hear that question, but to consume it and to allow it to consume us and everything we are.
Nominas vobis cum
et cum spiritu tuo.
crucis memoria, tans vera cordis gaudia, sed super me et omnia, eius crucis presentia.
as a jelly, sanitite or nomen tuum, avenit regum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Pane nostrum quotidiano da nobis hodie, et emitte nobis da vita nostra, sicut emet nos dimittimus da vitoribus nostrum, et ne nos inducas in tentationem.
Sed libera nos a malo.
Confidio de omnipotenti, fiata Maria sempre vergini, fiata Michele, Michele arcangelo, Beato Ioanni Baptiste, Sanctis Apostolis Petro et Paolo, Omnibus Sanctis et Tibi Pater, Quia peccare nimis cogitatione verbo et opere. Mea culpa, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Idio prequa beatam Mariam Sancta Virginem, Beatum Michaelum Archangelum, Beatum Ioannem Baptistam, Sanctos Apostolos et Te Pater. Orare pro mea Dominum Deum nostrum.
Miserata vestri omnipotens Deus et demises peccatus vest, nostris spiritu cantos et vita materia.
Amen.
Indulgentiam absolutionem et remissionem peccatorum nostrum tribuit nobis omnipotens et misericordes Domine.
Amen.
Janus Dei Ecce, Vitolus Peccata Mundi.
Thank you.
sanctifica me. Corpus Christi salva me.
Sanguis Christi inebria me. Aqua lateris Christi lava me.
Passio Christi conforta me. O bone Jesu, exaudi.
Dominus vobis cum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Mens et celestis virtute refacti, quaesimus Domini Deus noster, ut intervet veniens de sancto Pio sumo pontifice, cores efficiamur infides, et intuasimus caritate concordes. Per Dominum nostrum Iesum Christum, filium tuum, qui te convivet et regnat unitate et Spiritus Sanctus Deus, per omnia saecula saeculorum.
Amen.
Dominus vobis cum.
Et cum spiritu tuo.
Thank you. Nominos conserve Deu, et vivificet Deu, et beatum faciat Deum intera, et nun tradat Deu, in anima minimi corum meus.
Fiat manus tuas semper virum et dextori tuae.
Et super filium omnis quem confirmasti tibi.